Hello, cloud gurus. How would you feel to have Google call you a cloud digital leader? That will soon be possible. Also, Google has just given us DMS in GA, PHP for CF, and other interesting initialisms. All this and more in this episode. I'm your host, Matthias Andersen, and you're watching GCP This Month. First, let's take a look at our quick bites. Hey, it's kind of hard to keep up with all of these, but this month marks the opening of the Google Cloud region in Warsaw, Poland. This Europe Central 2 region makes 25 Google Cloud regions so far. There are also 8 more regions listed as coming soon, including Melbourne, Australia, and Toronto, Canada, eh? If you want to take advantage of Cloud SQL to have Google handle the unfun parts of managing your database, then you need a way to move your current MySQL or PostgreSQL data into the Cloud SQL instance that you stand up. That's where Google's Database Migration Service, or DMS, comes in. DMS can automatically configure your new Cloud SQL instance, replicate the data, and then keep it in sync until you're ready to cut over. Now that DMS is generally available, you should feel comfortable to put it to use. And with its super short cutover downtimes, why wouldn't you, right? Speaking of Cloud SQL, if you're interested in using it for SQL Server, Google has just sweetened that deal too. In particular, Cloud SQL for SQL Server now supports, in public preview, authentication through Active Directory. Now you can use the same identities as you're already using to connect securely to the Cloud SQL instance, thus really simplifying that cutover too. Now, if you're using Cloud Spanner, Google's horizontally scalable relational database that offers up to 5 nines of availability, you'll be very happy to learn that it now supports point-in-time recovery. This can let you recover data in whole or in part from any microsecond within the past 7 days. And of course, you can still use normal scheduled backups to go beyond 7 days. Amazing stuff. Cloud Spanner has also gotten some security improvements this month. In particular, you can now manage the encryption keys it uses yourself through Cloud Key Management, KMS, and optionally the Hardware Security Modules, HSMs. Furthermore, you can now require any Google support personnel who are helping you to explicitly request and gain approval to access your Cloud Spanner data. This access approval depends on the pre-existing access transparency support. If you're using any AutoML products or the classic version of AI platform, you should know that Google has just released in general availability their unified AI platform. AI Platform Unified, as it's known, offers the very nice ability to use the same API, user interface, and client libraries for both fully custom machine learning and AutoML usage. No word yet on whether or when Google might deprecate the old APIs. Speaking of deprecation, though, Google writes that Security Command Center Legacy, previously known as Cloud Security Command Center, and Event Threat Detection Legacy are being permanently disabled for all customers on June 7th, 2021. To continue benefiting from Security Command Center without an interruption in service, you must migrate your organizations to Security Command Center's standard tier or premium tier. Event Threat Detection, a built-in service of Security Command Center, is available only in the premium tier. End quote. We'll put a link in the video description for how you can migrate before the deadline. In other news, Google's Cloud Functions product can now run functions written in PHP. Now, some of you out there might have immediately started twitching, but hold on a minute. Regardless of how you feel about PHP, this is a good thing because it helps to open up the world of serverless to more people. Why shouldn't everyone be able to take advantage of functions as a service, regardless of the programming language they've been using? So to all you PHP developers out there, gates are open, come on in. Speaking of, that brings us to our gem for this month. Okay, this is some big news. In my opinion, this may be the most significant thing that Google has ever done to bring people into the GCP ecosystem. You probably think I'm exaggerating, but I'm not. I'm talking about Google's new Cloud Digital Leader certification in beta on May 3rd. Yes, I'm serious, a certification. The thing is, extremely few people use entry-level certifications like this one to prove their ability. Instead, almost everyone uses them to guide their learning. People have an interest to learn, whether because they need it for their job or because they're just curious or whatever, and a non-technical certification like this is a perfect way to start. It's attainable, it's focused, it's valuable, it's non-threatening, it's pure goodness! Now, if you're a non-technical person yourself, then a certification like this can build you a really valuable framework for understanding how the cloud works, both the public cloud in general and the Google Cloud specifically. You'll need to understand how it can simultaneously reduce total costs and dramatically increase business agility. The way Google puts it, a cloud digital leader can articulate the capabilities of Google Cloud core products and services and how they benefit organizations. The cloud digital leader can also describe common business use cases and how cloud solutions support an enterprise. Google also points out in the exam guide that this person needs to understand some key trade-offs, including the ones between costs versus responsibility and between level of management versus flexibility when comparing cloud services. It also gets into the shared responsibility between Google and us to manage security and other aspects of the systems that we build. Now, I don't have time in this video to talk about everything that this cert covers, but I guarantee that these are all super important things to understand if you have anything at all to do with the cloud. But to be honest, if you've made it to this point in the video, you probably do have some technical background, right? And you may already understand all of those things. So why then would I think that you would still care about this entry-level certification? Well, because can you imagine if every person at your work, everyone you talk with each day, if they actually understood all of those things that I just mentioned too? Wow! Being able to speak the same language does not mean just English. In this context, it means understanding the technology and being able to communicate intelligently about it. So, whatever your background, you might want to get this cert so you can call yourself a cloud digital leader. And then you can lead the others around you to do the same, to raise your whole organization's baseline of understanding. That makes everyone more efficient. Now, speaking of efficiency, we've made a guide on how you can best use all of Google's cloud certifications to guide and focus your learning so that you can succeed in your work. We'll link to that in the video description. But if you've been wanting to learn about the Google Cloud Platform, then regardless of your previous background, this is a great place to start. We can all be cloud digital leaders. Well, I really do hope you will join us. Join us in learning about the Google Cloud for a start, but I also think it would be great to have you join us on our new A Cloud Guru Discord. Hop on and you can chat with thousands of other learners and lots of us training architects too. And not only do we chat through text, we also periodically host office hours where we can converse live in audio video channels. Join us and get quick answers to the all sorts of random questions that might be bouncing around in your head. Plus, it can be really encouraging to interact with other people who really get you as you study and play around with all this cool new cloud technology. Oh, and this being a YouTube video, I'm supposed to encourage you now to like and subscribe, of course, so please, you know, do that. Ideally, it's because you find videos like this valuable, right? So, what do you think of Google's new Cloud Digital Leader certification? Are you as excited about this as I am? Will you become such a leader? The conversation has already started on our Discord. Or leave us a comment here on this video to let us know. But whatever you choose, stay safe and keep being awesome, cloud gurus.